last night we stopped over at Thrupp outside the Jolly Boatman, and we're moving on today towards hopefully Jericho in Oxford. This is Duke's Lock, and a spin round. Duke's Cut bears off to the right, and we're going round to the left, which is towards Oxford. This is. That's Duke's Cut over there going on to Lechlade. So one day we will do that, but not today. And just over there are the old stables that I did a bit more of in a previous vlog. We're off to heading to Oxford.
Your birthplace.
Yes, where I was born, Oxford.
quarter for load of boats. Both the Pans Union and the South Oxford levels were low. This is just scraping her bum on the bottom. She ain't that deep, she's only 2.5 foot.
It's also, alright, we've done this stretch before. However, it was earlier in the year.
That's true.
And it was in April. So there wasn't a lot of leaf out.
There's hardly any flow at the moment.
Of course, coming down this time of year, which is now we're into September, there's a lot of vegetation, lots of trees, bushes, blackberry bushes. Seen a few of those close up.
You've got a weird way of coming out the South Oxford onto the Sheepwash Canal. Oh, this is locked. Which is fine when it's a good flow on. When there's no flow, it doesn't aid you whatsoever. We ended up in the bushes.
Yeah, so it was it was an interesting morning to get up. It didn't help that when we started off there was nobody about. As soon as we got into the lock, we had a boat immediately behind us. So as soon as we came out the lock to moor up onto the landing to do this
manoeuvre,
another boat that was coming the opposite direction decided to come round. So that really sort of put us in a very awkward position.
I couldn't have even gone out normally and just turned right because this boat was in the way. So I tried doing a manoeuvre where you have to wing the boat so your bow is facing back towards the lock and then you let the flow, allegedly, take the boat, bow out and then you go down the sheep wash.
Yeah.
But there was next to no flow, so I had to do it all with the engine when I boat in the way.
Oh, no, we've seen that one quite a few times. Somerton, we've passed Somerton a few times, sorry dear.
Yeah, I had to do it with a boat with its nose up against the lock gate and its stern in front of me, and I just didn't have enough room to swing round completely, so I had to do it in separate manoeuvres. And all the lady on the other boat could say was, well, I don't know how you can do it with an old engine like that and a boat that long. So I shrugged my shoulders. She said, you need a bow thruster. And that really upset me.
Don't do bow thrusters.
No, you just need to know how to handle a boat.
So it's been nice. It's been, we had rain last night, which was forecast. We had a lot of heavy rain in the night. We decided we'd push on today.
Got a bit of wind today. I don't know if it's affecting the camera.
Wednesday.
Yes, it's Wednesday. Yes,
I think most of the children have gone back to school because where we were moored up last night at Jericho, it was really, really noisy with children, really happy and cheerful in the playground. But they're not so much happy and cheerful.
It's
not
so good for the winter.
Yeah, the Celtic lady, we've seen her as well. It's actually quite nice to see some of these boats again. We've seen on and off, up and down. But it is quite strange coming down a familiar canal that we've done before, different time of the year. It's certainly not the same. Because there's different things to look out for. The water levels and all sorts of things, the vegetation, the blind corners that we didn't have it, earlier in the year. So it does make you think when is the best time to actually go cruising.
I'm in my eyes, I can't put my hat on because it keeps blowing off.
So we're leaving Oxford.
Yeah.
So we've come through the Isis Rock.
What's he doing?
Can't see.
Trip boat stopped in front of us.
Oh right, okay.
Right, there's another one coming.
We've got another one coming, so the manoeuvring of the two different trip boats, a day boat and a sightseeing boat. Yes, it is totally different times of the year. So if you've said, oh, you've done the canal a particular time, try to do it again a different time of the year because it's so different.
Lock's down here.
trip boat was ahead of us and actually pulled out in front of us as we came round the corner from under
the
bridge.
That's not a problem in itself.
But
he was faster than us anyway.
Well, yes, I know he was faster.
Now he's windy.
But the problem is he had no indications that he was actually going to wind, but he suddenly has decided to do this manoeuvre and then start beeping when he's actually finally looked over his shoulder and saw us coming. We're just going to bring back Never Enough to a safe position while he can wind.
Yeah, it's in the wind of the lower the river as
yeah.
well. Yeah. Lower the river into the current.
Done for a while, manually open the lock. Thank you, cheers. And the big wide beam coming behind, big barge, very kindly decided to wind the gates open for us so I could get back on. That was very nice of him. So that was Iffley lock with no lock keeper on today, so we had to do it, and then the power broke. Thanks for watching. See you next time.